What's up, you guys? Marty Schwartz here from GuitarJams.com. Got a special guest in the studio. We've got John Konecki, also known as Cones sometimes.
Yeah.
Don't want to sell you short, but probably at the moment best known for playing guitar with Tenacious D.
That's true.
One of my all-time favorite bands of
Mine
all
too.
Time. Yeah?
Yeah.
So you're lucky. You get to play in one of your favorite bands.
Totally.
That's so awesome. You've done some special guesting here at Guitar Jams, and I love when you come and do the fingerstyle stuff. So I picked the most requested fingerstyle song, and you broke it down beautifully. In fact, there were unicorns hoofing at the back door of the studio when you were
good,
playing that
good
intro.
To know, yeah.
You know, I had to turn them away, but but they'll be back, I'm sure, especially when you break it down. But anyway, just real quick, you guys check out all of Cone's stuff. I'm just going to leave a link for what Cones is up to down there, and then also a link for GuitarJams.com, my website that has a bunch of lessons. Now, real quick, segue. No different cameras, but let's segue. This is in a different tuning, right?
Mm-hmm.
So I've got you're already in the tuning because you were playing that intro. I'm in standard tuning.
Okay.
So you tell me what I got to do to get into the right tuning.
Cool. It's as simple as dropping your low E down to D.
So I'm just going to match it up with my D string. Okay.
Nice. And then do the same thing to your high E.
Oh, okay. So I'm going to match my high E up to my D as well. And I always find, at least for myself, to go below
and then
tune
scoop
up
it back.
To it.
Yeah.
Now, obviously, if you have a tuner, you want this to be a D, and you want this high one to be a D. The unicorns are coming back.
Yeah.
I hear them now.
Okay,
so we got a lot to teach, so why don't we just zoom in on you and break it down?
Cool.
Thanks, dude.
Awesome. All right, so we're going to start with just the intro of the song, which is basically just a... an alternating thumb between these two D's, the 6th and the 4th string. And there's a little kind of melody thing on top that he repeats about 6 times before John Paul Jones comes in with that mandolin line. So it goes like this, and it's... All I'm fretting down here on the left hand is my first finger is on the 2nd fret of the 3rd string, and then my 2nd finger is on the 3rd fret of the 2nd string. I'm not really using this 3rd string, but it's there anyway because we're going to use the shape later. So just kind of getting familiar with it. It's going to look like a D sus 2, but it's not. It's actually a D5 chord because the E is tuned down to D. So it's neither major nor minor. And then the picking pattern so you got this top note in between, so you got 6-2-4-2-6-2 it goes. Open it up a little bit. I was just playing it kind of more muted so you could hear the exactly how the pattern works, but you almost want to kind of open it up more and then try to experiment with a little bit of dynamics on this top note, because I noticed when he plays it, sometimes it's almost inaudible, other times it's there. It's like, but that dynamic thing is gonna make it feel a little better rather than just... So open it up and let them ring. swirl your hand around a little bit, get different sounds out of this thing. Okay, so that happens six times, and then on the seventh, you could just stay there and keep doing that if you want, which is what he does, or we could cop that cool little mandolin thing that happens, and that's up here. It comes out of this riff around here, so I'll show you where it comes in context. There's four, five, six. So right after you start the seventh time. And then all we're doing here is just barring the seventh fret. And we're going to play second string, first string. Then going up to the eighth fret on the second string. And then back down to the seven. So. And then we're going to bring our third finger over, get the ninth fret of the third string. So we got. And then seven. So you might want to keep that bar down over one, two, and three on that seventh fret. We're going to go. Whoop. So that's second string. We go seventh fret, eighth fret, seventh fret. 9th fret 3rd string, 7th fret 3rd string, 9th fret 3rd string, ending on 7 and 7. And then you gotta jump. So the next part, we're gonna jump down here and get this. Okay, so that's what functions as the verse in the song. And this little top melody sort of reflects what the vocal is doing. So this is going to be a little bit more complicated picking pattern here. I'm going to show you, I'm going to walk it through it here. So first thing we want to do is fret this weird shape, which is... We got 5 and 5 on the 6th string and the 4th string. That's going to be our little alternating bass. So again, we have this alternating bass thing going on, and it's playing octaves. We come in right out of the gate with this top melody note, which is the 5th fret of the 1st string. We want to use our pinky because we got to squeeze down here and get some other stuff with our first finger. So we're going... So that's going... using my third finger and my thumb, and then rolling down backwards my middle finger, first finger. So I'm gonna start with 6 and 1, and we're gonna roll from third finger on first string, second finger, second string, and then at that point our thumb is on the octave bass. So. Now, it's almost like if you could get this first thing and allow that thumb to keep a consistent octave going, you pretty much got the whole thing. So at that point, this melody note comes in on an in-between. So let's dig it just up to there. So right after you hit this, now you're ready for that low note again. So now we're going. And that's 6, 2, 4. So then in context, we'll take you back. Whoops. So then in context, we're going to take you back from the top. And then, same pattern again as we did on the first one, but we're going to bring our pinky over to the 5th fret of the 2nd string. So now our melody notes are coming from. So we got a roll here. So we go sixth string and second string, thumb and second finger on this one. And we're gonna hit third string open, and then hit our bass note again, our high bass note, and then. That next melody note is coming from the open, what is a D string, with the high E string, the first string. And then same pattern that we did on the second half of the first half. Right. And then we want to lift that pinky off. And then we can kind of complete the run from there.